bit we're changing. But thank you for inviting us over here. For us, it's a pleasure to introduce you to the Solar Future in the Netherlands, in The Hague. Most of the people know Amsterdam, but to be honest, The Hague is a very nice city where you have some really nice retail going on as well. So if you come to the Netherlands, please visit The Hague also in the near future. So we became a retailer, but Q&A is actually a research and consultants firm for retailers. And the reason why we started with the Store of the Future is that we see that a lot of retailers are struggling. I mean, they see that the behavior of consumers is changing. There's a lot of technology, and they actually don't know where to invest in. And we want to help them with that. So that's also the purpose of our business, help retailers to improve. And now we do that in a totally different way because we opened the Store of the Future in The Hague. The main question is how will the shoppers, how will they shop in 2030? For us, that's also a very good question. And what we say is, if you want to see look at 2030, please also focus on the people who are shopping mainly in 2030. So therefore, the millennials are a very important target group for research. It's a very important target group for a Store of the Future. And it's also where the story started. Because of what we did, my girlfriend, she's a teacher. And she's teaching boys and girls from between 13 and 17 years old. And each year I have the opportunity to do something with research with that group. And 2 years ago, that started with this. So I just asked the students, please write down to me the story of the future, how would it look like? And in total, we collected, I think, more than 1,000 of these little stories. And there was the inspiration, based on this inspiration, we started the initiative of the Store of the Future. And what you see, I mean, it's all in Dutch for you, so it's hard to read. What you see is some have difficulties with writing. That's probably because they grown up digital. But they write a lot about technology in stores. They write a lot about the employees, so the staff in the stores. And some also write about robots or a new field communication of other kind of technologies. But you see that products, employees, and technology, that's where millennials or young, even younger people write a lot about. And that was for us the reason to start thinking about opening a store of the future, because we want to assist retailers in making the right investments. What you see is that the millennials, compared to other generations, it's probably what you know as well as here in the UK. I mean, they're digital grown-ups, so that's 99%, so almost 100%. And what you also see is that they still like to shop in stores. Of course, online is a very important channel for them, but what we see is that they like to shop offline. And what's for us important to know is, okay, how will they shop offline, and what are they looking for in the environment? And that's the reason why we opened Store of the Future together with the City Council of The Hague. We also guided them in a project to become the smart shopping city of the Netherlands. And one of their targets was to have a retail innovation lab in The Hague. And based on the ideas we had, we decided to open it in The Hague. And it was also a company who offered us a very nice location for a very low price, I have to admit. So that's also the reason why we ended up in The Hague eventually. What we did is we designed a customer journey model. You will also find it on the table within the print. And actually, where we are focusing on is, the search part, of course, people do the search part in the offline environment, but we see that it happens a lot online. Our main focus is on everything what you see within the shop part. So it's about customizing, browsing, be inspired, get recommendation, be advised, fit and test, loyalty benefits, checkouts. So what we are testing mainly has to do with that part of the customer journey. And So what we created is an environment, which actually is a retail innovation lab, where we can gather a lot of feedback from consumers about how they react to the technology we offered over there. And what I mentioned before, I mean, retailers have a lot of questions, so that's the reason why we opened it. And it's a retail innovation lab, and what we do is we bring consumers in. You see many store of the futures. I mean, I don't know if you know the Loop in Antwerpen. It's also a store of the future, but it's only a B2B environment. And I think the most important part of our store is that we get the feedback from the consumers, because they can really tell us what they like about technology and what you need to improve as a company and also as a retailer to make technology successful. So it's also a place where we give the opportunity to retailers to test innovations even before they invest in it and introduce it in all of the stores, for instance. And it's also an environment where we have a lot of events and presentations. So it's we have a lot of companies who just book our store for having presentations also like this and having interesting brainstorm sessions. So that's what our store is about. We created a big network around it. We have more than 60 partners, and actually on each area of the store, we found a partner. So for New Babylon, for instance, that's the shopping center where we're located. So they offered us the opportunity to rent a location. Joost Fries, the retail company, it's a company who is very strong in designing store concepts. Redefco, real estate, it's a big mixture of companies. And what we do is we connect these companies to retailers, and together with those retailers, we are doing research on the future of retail. What we created is this is the floor plan of our environment. So we have 350 square meters where we created a lot of shopping shops, and within those shops we show the technologies together with the retailers. And we will be open for almost a year. So we opened was the end of June this year, and next summer until now it's the story that we have to close it. But I have to admit that there are quite some cities in the Netherlands who are also interested in having a project like this within their cities. So there's an opportunity that we also will open some other stores in after we close this store. But it will be the second half of 2016. Open for 365 days, a lot of events. And what's also interesting is the sidetracks, because what we will do with the sidetracks is we will combine experts around certain topics. So it can be big data, or it can be loyalty, other kind of business models, where we'll create white papers, which we can also share with the rest of the retail in the Netherlands. So that's our store. Why is it important for you as a company to participate? I think it's very worthwhile that the feedback which we can gather there from the consumers, but also from the experts in the field, that's very worthwhile. They can tell you what they like about it, about an innovation, why they like it, and what you need to change to improve it. And especially the last part, what do we need to change to improve? That's the feedback which we got, which we gather a lot in our store, and I will show it you based on a few examples. And for the experts, of course, we got the same kind of information, but for the partners to be part of the store of the future, it's of course it's also an area where they can showcase their technology to the rest of the world. So for them, it's also a showroom environment, I have to admit. That's some of them really go into it for the showroom, but most of them, they just want to have the feedback of the consumers as well. So it's an innovation and a feedback lab. There's a little guy on the left. I mean, it's a store of the future. It's nice that was the first person who entered the store. And the reason why he entered the store is because that on the floor it's interactive. So his parents are walking by, and a little guy is entering this. So what we notice is young people are really attracted to technology. old people on the right side, a bit less. But if you introduce them to technology, and that's, you can also see it on the face of this this woman. I think she was around 70 or so. But also they like technology. But you really have to introduce them. You have to teach them. But in the end, they will like it and they will use it as well. And for us, the big advantage is that we gather the information, from all the shoppers, and that's very interesting for research from our side. What you saw on this little movie is a bit of the environment restore the future. So it's a shop concept where we can test a lot of technologies, but on the science perspective, for instance, we can also do a lot of testing. So how do people react to the different kind of signage, for instance. And we created an area with the food area. So Le Plas, it's a famous in the Netherlands for food. We have Mein Müsli, it's an online retailer from Germany, who also opened some stores in Germany already. They also have big plans to come to the Netherlands. So they opened their store in our store in the future to gather information from consumers about their products. So it's more about the products and it's about the innovation. But they use the environment to learn how they can grow in the Netherlands. So that's our store. From this science point of view, this is actually what we opened 2 weeks ago. But what happens over there is that your hand actually turns into a mouse. So based on the camera, we have consumers here who can play around with the screen, and we mainly use this screen for a self-guided tour, because the problem is that all people who are entering the store, we cannot assist them all in the proper way, especially when it's a lot of traffic. So we use this technology to advise and suggest to visitors where to go. And the reaction on this kind of technology is very positive from their side. But it's also what we want to show to retailers, that this kind of technology is available use in their stores. What we do together with SAP and Mammut is mainly technology. It's data driven, but it's also decision driven, because the technology is based on consumers to let them make the decision by themselves. What you see over there is the product, what you pick up, the screen will get turned interactive based on the product which you use. People really like the ID behind this, but I have to admit over here, content is king. And the content which we show over there is not relevant for consumers. So that's also the message which we can give to Mammut. If you invest in this technology, there's a future, but there's only a future when your content is right. And that's very important actually for every technology which you introduce in a store. The content really needs to fit to the purpose of the consumer. And that's what we learn a lot. So we got a lot of information, research about what kind of content do we need to show there. And what you see is that over here we presented it based on movies. People don't like movies in this situation. They rather have technical features or reviews from consumers, for instance. That kind of information is more relevant towards them. So that's for that part. Leap, it's a refurbished Apple products. It's a very innovative retailer from the Netherlands. Growing very fast, and what we do over here is on 5 square meters, we can actually sell the full product launch, but the only thing is that the people who are working in the store, they're not expert in Apple products. So what we offer over here is a connection to experts of Leap in other stores in The Hague. So if people enter our store, we can give them advice based on the experts on another location. And over here also, consumers are very positive about this ID, but they're very positive about ID when they're shopping online. And for them, it's not a relevant experience in the store environment. So that's also very interesting information for us. Also to share with Leap and of course with other retailers, because for the online, I mean online chat, the video, I think there's a big future for that part, but not in a physical environment. Then they really need like to talk to people and not to screens. So that's the information you can we can gather over there. Paddy is a big sports retailer. We combine it together with White Table and with Epson for the projection. And what we do over there is we created an interactive floor, which you can see on the video. And based on the shoe we are wearing, I mean, we have two shoes, and of course we have also two movies over there. So one is for tennis shoes, and the other is for running. So the moment you enter this floor, the floor will get will turn interactive based on the shoes you're wearing. And there's the idea behind this is of course that there's some RFID technology within it. And also here you see that consumers they really like the idea, but the problem is the movie is too slow. It's not reactive enough, and that's the reason why consumers actually, I mean, they like the idea. But yeah, it really has to be very well and very interactive based on what consumers are doing. Otherwise, it's just something nice, but it's not more than that. So that's but it's very interesting to show to retailers. I mean, they don't know all about this kind of technologies, and for us it's important to show it. 2 weeks ago, we opened the store of Adam Underwear. It's actually also based on projection, the same kind of technology. And over here, we can show to consumers, what's in the package and also how it fits. So this is also a fast way to fit and test products. I mean, of course, you probably know the digital mirrors. I mean, this is also a way to showcase that. And very positive reaction from consumers as well for that one. Hema, this app, I also brought it on my iPad, so you can test it later on. But what we did together with Volition, we digitalized their complete cosmetic line. And over here, I will show the movie again. What you can see is you can really try on makeup. So you can go to the product line. I think it's more than 200 products within the app. And on a very real base, you can test the technology on the makeup on the iPad. And over here as well, consumers are very positive about the technology. But the point with this technology is, it's only one part of the customer journey. So people they like the functionality of the application. But the problem is once they selected the color which is the best color for them, they don't know where to find it in a store. So that's also what you need to take in consideration when you're building these kind of technologies. Look at the total customer journey and don't stop it somewhere. That's what we receive from them. Other reactions for consumers. If this is possible, then cosmetics will grow heavily online. I mean, that's also the feedback which you get from consumers. I mean, they say, okay, just give it on my phone, on my iPad, and I can do it at home. So for Hema, that's also interesting. If they're investing in these kind of technologies, there's a part of the future of cosmetics online. So that's also the information which you can gather there. What we do together with Riviera Maison, it's a wholesale living retailer. We still have to 3D render the products. We do it together with IMDG. But what you see within their app, this app is called Amikaze. You can really, based on augmented reality, take the products of Riviera Maison at home on your device. So this is really what consumers like. I mean, only the problem is over here, we can show it in the store environment. People say they really like the technology, but we want to see it at home. And we want to see it at home when they're in the store. So that also means that that you need an application where you can really upload the pictures from your situation at home to test it in the real store environment. So they like the technology, but you really need to take into account how people want to use it. So there's very interesting feedback.
This is actually has nothing to do with technology, but it's just an experiment. Van Haren is a big shoe retailer in the Netherlands, and the experiment is all about shopping with bags is history. What we try is based on these 50 shoes which we have to really sell them. What we want to experiment is if people are willing to buy shoes without taking them directly into their home, so that we can ship them. The only problem is that we only have these items, so we don't have the full size range. And that's also the feedback we have from consumers. So until now, we haven't sold any shoe because people want to first try them, and if they're convinced it's the right size for them, it's fine that we ship it to their home. But that's very relevant feedback. Also, when you look at stock levels in stores, for instance, so it's just an experiment. It has nothing to do with technology actually, but for me, it's also part of the future. Less stock in low traffic locations, for instance. And of course, there's a lot of data. You probably know the counters for the clients. We also use the software provided by Prism. Prism Skylabs is based on cameras, and with these cameras, we can actually make analysis based on the traffic in each part of the store. And the data behind it, you can also do heat mapping, of course, for the total store. But what you see happening in this movie is that we also can actually slice and dice based on particular areas. So you can really do analysis on actually on a display or even on a square meter base. So that's very interesting information for us. Also to see if we make changes in the store, what will happen to the routing, for instance. So this is for us a very important data which we get on that item. What's next? By March we will have a robot for Alp Stories. So in the movie you see this robot. It's called Baltasar, where you can customize your shampoo, for instance. So we will bring it to the store. We will start with 3D printing of buttons on jeans for America Today jeans company. And at the moment, there's still no beacon in the store of the future, and we will start with it by the beginning of 2016. The app already is being developed, and then we will also do the research and the feedback part on beaconing, how consumers are reacting to that. And one of the reasons that we haven't started with it yet is that it's very hard for retailers, and especially for us, also for Store of the Future, to even have people installing apps on their phone. So that's why we are still happy that we didn't even start with this part, because that's one of the biggest problems I think retailers have, but that will come. What we are looking for, and this might be some interesting cases for here as well. What we see, I mean, we use quite a lot of signs, so we have some reaction, we have three or four screens, but the problem is for each signage solution which we have now, we have to create their own content. And what we are actually looking for is a content management system where you can use the same content on multiple platforms, so actually multiple signage platforms. That's a solution where we are looking for. Size measurement, that's very relevant for some fashion and shoe retailers. So technology could be based on video, but can also be based on Apple or iPads, that people can really make a good estimation of their size. That's very important for us. Big database, personal in-store interaction, because what you now see is that the interaction of course we can make interaction a bit more personal. Because it's male, female, or based on if they're old or not, but we really want to make it personal. So big data, which we maybe can gather in apps, how can we show that on a personal base on the digital signage? That's also something where we're looking at. For loyalty, I think that in the future of loyalty, especially shopping centers, will also have to do with dwell time. So how long are people staying there? That could be a solution of loyalty in the future, that you also look at dwell time. Until now it's still not there, but for us it would be interesting to have it. Customer feedback tools, very fast and easy, that's important for us. If you look at sectors until now and D&Y, yeah, for us it's not, we don't see that many innovation in D&Y. Opticians, I think the Olition app which I showed from HEMA could be very useful for that retail sector, but we're also looking for solutions which really suit to that needs. And in-store self-service apps, because what you see is, of course, store employees are the most important for consumers, but if they're not available, you need to have some self-service. So we're also looking for apps which we can test in the future. And there's probably more, and based on the session that we will have over here, we will probably get it. So if you look at the sort of future and especially the customer journey model, the elements which we're particularly looking at is raise awareness in plan route, customization, get suggestions, loyalty benefits, and share opinions with the company. Those are the elements we're really looking for. And that's it for now. Questions?